Start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
All right, thank you. Roll call.
Okay, we have the dust collector, Lance McCullough.
Here.
Trustee Mike Lewandowski.
Here.
Trustee Bassett.
Here.
Assessor Mason.
Here.
Supervisor Alberico.
Here.
Trustee Boyce.
Here.
And Trustee Morelli.
Here.
All right. First, I'd like to start the public hearing, basically for any citizens wishing to address the board.
Budget ready, so it got passed in March and April, I believe, got passed.
So basically, line items for the renovation of the building, you know, stuff was basically, I had to guess at that, those line items because the drawings weren't done yet and the construction bids weren't in yet, and I had no clue as to what it was going to quite cost. So I guessed at it and I didn't do as well as I thought, so I'm going to put, transfer some more money into those line items to pay for the building. Those are the two change, line items that I changed, the one in the senior, and the one, I think I put $200,000 in the senior, which brought it up from $500,000, now don't quote me on this, but to $700,000, and I don't remember, I think it was $900,000, I brought it up to $101,000. That's a $300,000 in the town fund, line item. The other line item, I did create a new line item for settlements, and I put some money into the settlement line item for a situation that we're going to be, taking care of in the next week here. I think we're going to settle our dispute that's been going on for 15 years with a lawsuit. So I did put that line item in there. We did move some monies in the clerk's area. Basically, her line items didn't go up at all. She just moved out from contingency to a salary. And also, our bottom line stayed the same. So that's basically the only change that was budget.
Curiosity, what was the dispute?
I'm sorry?
Curiosity, what was the dispute?
Please, 15 years dispute. Please come up so we can hear you. So you're right.
And I don't plan to do this. I didn't think, but I was just curious what the...
Our water department over down at Fairmont, we run the water department. We have a township board. We have a board that runs up 800 houses down in the Fairmont area. Back 15, 20 years ago, whatever it was, there was a contract, and it was signed, and the former board didn't feel they were doing their job, so they fired the company, and it was a breach of contract. We lost them. So we went through the courts, and now we got to settle. So basically, it was something that was left on our plate, we got to clean it up. All right, is there any other discussion on the budget? In this public hearing?
The only thing I wanted to tell Carl is the budget, the amended budget, is online as well as the approved budget. So they're both online if you look, and I'm not know if you're familiar with our website, but on the side, when you go onto the website, you can click on each office holder's department. Under the clerk's department, it has the postings on there. If you click on that, you will find this display copy was on there. So I'm sorry that you had a hard time finding it, but it is there.
That's on me.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, if there's no other discussion here tonight, I think we can adjourn the public hearing. I will take a motion.
Make a motion.
I get a motion by Barb.
We have 20 minutes. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
I was just curious about the budgetary items and the changes, and I went on the website, but I didn't navigate it properly, so that's why I didn't find the files that apparently are there. So, little learning curve using it, that's all.
I'll second the motion.
I got a second by Michael Lewandowski. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you very much. We will go to our meeting at 7 o'clock.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States.
like to call a roll call, please.
Collector Lance McCullough.
Here.
Trustee Mike Wondolsky.
Here.
Trustee John Bodicich.
Present.
Assessor Debbie Mason.
Here.
Supervisor Ron Borrego.
Here.
Highway Commissioner John Chalinski.
Here.
Trustee Bart Boyce.
Here.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Here.
And we have with us our attorney Gary Mueller.
Present.
And our deputy clerk Jessica.
All right, before we start the meeting, I do want to make a quick statement. I know life is full of highs and lows. I wanted to start out tonight saying how happy and wonderful it was for the Cubs to win. It was a great thing for the Chicago and the surrounding areas, and I was elated by that. And low is one of our employees lost a son yesterday. And I want to just say how my heart really goes out to her, as I'm sure this whole board feels the same way. 39-year-old man passed away. She'll be off in the next couple of weeks, I think, or this week. But I just wanted to give her my heartfelt sorrow to her family, to her and her family. All right. That being said, everybody should have in their pack for the road and bridge the minutes of the monthly meeting of October 3rd and the bid opening of October 27th. We need a motion to pass the minutes. I'm going to make a motion.
I'll make a motion
by Barbara Boyce.
Second.
Second by John Bodicich. Any questions in the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's it. Thank you very much. You have the bills. $64,490.36. I do need a motion to pay the bills.
So
I have a motion by John Bodicich.
I'll second it.
And a second by Michael Wondolsky. Any questions on tonight's bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Wondolsky?
Yes.
Bodicich?
Yes.
Alberico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right, motion carries.
Supervisor Borrego, excuse me. Could you have the bid opening from October 27th? Road and Bridge, please.
Did you have the date on there?
I thought I did. Who did you say?
Yeah, I did say the opening. You did have my call. All right, any citizens wishing to address the board? Hearing none, we'll go to the Highway Commissioner's report.
Thank you. Well, we're getting on in the season. That's scary times with the winter coming up. we're done shipping for the season. Having a couple issues with a few trucks. We're getting repaired. We did go out for a bid that I think I mentioned last week. So we are picking our person, the lowest the bidder. So we'll be doing Thornton, McGregor, and Hammond from McGregor to Farrell, along with replacing three culverts on Thornton. And we have a 60-inch culvert that was recommended that instead of pulling that big culvert out, that we can line it. And they have a concrete liner. It's kind of some neat things, but the integrity is exactly the same as a new pipe without having to go through the expense of digging the old one out. So the bid opening went really well. Thank you to the clerk for letting us use her office for that. We're going to be putting the snow equipment on. I hate to say that, but they're talking about a little more snow than normal. We have plenty of salt. The guys right now are just trying to get as many roads patched as we can before they stop making the hot patch. Away we go with the winter coming up here. So, things are going well.
All right. You're talking about putting gloves on and everything. It's November 7th. I still see people in shorts.
Yes, yes, yes. And I tell you, that was great weather for baseball. had a very nice opportunity to go to the Monday night football game with my father-in-law. And it was nice and warm. Being from Florida, he didn't freeze, so that's always a good thing as well.
All right. I don't have any other business in the highway. Call for adjournment.
So,
I John Bastich.
I'll second.
Second by who?
Barb.
Barb Weiss. Second by Barb Weiss. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's it, thank you very much. Okay, moving on to our general assistance. Again, you have the minutes in your bag from the monthly meeting of October 3rd, 2016. If you need a motion to pass the minutes. Motion by Barb Weiss.
Second.
Second by, I got a second by John Bastich. Any questions of tonight's minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries, thank you. Bills, $10,059.07. Need a motion to pay the bills for the general assistance.
So move.
Motion by John Bastich.
I'll second it.
Second by Michael Lewandowski. Any questions tonight's bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Lewandowski.
Yes.
Bastich.
Yes.
Alberico.
Yes.
Weiss.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right, motion carries. Any citizens wishing to address the board for the general assistance? Hearing none, I have no new business. I do have the old business. You have your monthly financial aid report. Quick, 10 new applications were taken out. Two of them weren't returned. Eight were. Four applications from the previous month for a total of 11 applications. Three of them are waiting for information. Two are being processed as we speak. The number of denied were one for income was greater than what's acceptable for general assistance. Two failed to bring in proper information, and one person withdrew their application. So right now we have six that requalified, three that were denied for requalification. We had two on general emergency assistance and six on general assistance this month. Any questions on general assistance?
I just have a quick question, if I may.
Sure.
What would classify emergency as compared to general assistance?
Emergency assistance, we do it, it's a one-time assistance that we will allow a person, and they can only do it once every 24 months. As opposed to something that's out of working. Can, you know, if emergency is something that comes up in a situation, they need emergency assistance right now, they can do it once every 2 years, as opposed to staying in the regular system. All right, I have nothing else in general assistance. I would ask for adjournment.
So moved.
We have a motion by Jen Bastich. Second by Barbara Boyce. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. All right, moving on to our senior fund. Again, you have the minutes in your packet from our monthly meeting of October 3rd, 2016. If you need a motion to pass the minutes.
Make the motion.
Make a motion by John Bastich.
A second.
A second by Barbara Boyce. Any questions in the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Motion carries, thank you. You have the bills of $47,958.82. You need a motion to pay the bills?
Make the motion.
I have a motion by John Bastich.
I'll second it.
I got a second by Dean Morelli. Any questions or bills for the senior fund? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Bastich.
Yes.
Lewandowski.
Yes.
Alberico.
Yes.
Weiss.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right. Motion carries. Again, any citizens wishing to address the board here tonight for the senior fund? Hearing none. I have no new business in senior. We have a couple of things in old business I just wanted to bring up really quick. We did have shingle shots again. Another outing for people. So far this year, we've done 126 shingle shots. He didn't say that three times. So a total of, with our first year, that pilot program year, we did 25 that year. So we're up to 151, over 150 people we've done so far. We already have a list of people that are waiting for more money for next year's budget. About 20 or 25 people on that list already. So people are very interested in this program. I'm glad we're able to do it. We do have probably about enough money left to do 7 more shots, so we take the first 7 off the list that's waiting and try to get them yet in this year. So if there's money left after that, we'll whittle it down 2 at a time or 1 at a time until we use up the funding. So real happy with that. The other thing I wanted to bring up was our senior breakfast, which was this time last month. It was a very good turnout. Everybody had a good time. But I know there's always a big list of people that want to come. I just want to let our audience know and our people out there know that you can start calling the office now to make reservations for next year's senior breakfast. Call early because it does fill up fast. If you want to get a seat at it, we do it Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. This year it'll be October 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, 2017. So call the office, 815-838-0380. Make your reservations. I have nothing else in our senior fund. Call for an adjournment.
So moved.
Motion by John Vasich.
Second.
Second by Barbara Boyce. All in favor? Opposed? Eyes ahead. Thank you. Okay, moving on to our town fund. We're pretty good tonight. All right, our town fund. I'm going to go out of order. I'm sorry tonight, guys. I do want to go out of order here tonight on our thing. First thing I want to do here tonight is ask citizens addressing the board. Go to the town fund. Hearing none. The next thing I want to do is approve the amended 2016-2017 budget from budget number 2016-1. So I do need a motion to amend the budget.
Before we amend the budget, can we just make it clear what exactly the money is going to be amended for so that everyone has a clear understanding of that?
Sure.
Thank you.
Why don't we make the motions first and then we can do the discussion.
Okay, I'll make the motion.
Right. A motion by Michael Lewandowski.
Second.
Second by John Vasich. All right. Any questions? And obviously, Michael has a question. What we are amending the budget for, there's a couple of little line items. We did discuss this in our public hearing, which was tonight at 6:30. But for the audience at TV, basically, the new building that we built, or we're having worked on renovating right now, when we put this budget together back in February this year, it was before the drawings were done, and before the architectural drawings were done, and before the bids went out and bids for the building. So I had no clue as to what to put in those line items. I put, I believe it was $500,000 in our senior fund and $900,000 in our town fund for the building. Bids came out a little higher than that, so I wanted to raise the town fund up to 1.1, adding $300,000 to it. And our senior fund, $200,000, which will bring up to $700,000 in that fund. The only other line item, we did put a line item there for settlements to settle the long-term dispute that we've been having for the last 20 years, 15 years. That's coming to a conclusion, so I need to put a line item in there for that. And I think Denise moved some money around in her clerk's budget, but it didn't change the numbers. It just moved it from contingency to assessments. So those are the only changes on this budget.
Thank you.
Any other questions or statements from anything you want to bring up?
Hearing none, committee will roll call, please.
Wodehouse.
Yes.
Monson.
Yes.
Alberico.
Yes.
Boyce.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right, motion carries. Thank you very much. Now we'll go to the minutes. Everybody should have in their pack minutes from the monthly meeting of October 3rd, 2016. I do need a motion to pass the minutes.
I'll second it.
Motion by Barbara Boyce and second by Michael Wodehouse. Any questions in the minutes? I do have one typo. We talked about the food pantry and Mr. Naylor's name was missing. D instead of M. With that correction, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's it. Thank you very much. We have the bills of $872,801.38. Do we need a motion to pay the bills?
Make a motion.
I've got a motion by Barbara Boyce. Second by Jen Lattisich. Any questions or bills? Hearing none, committee roll call, please.
Wodehouse.
Yes.
Monson.
Yes.
Alberico.
Yes.
Boyce.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right, motion carries. Thank you very much. All right, I have assessors.
The only thing I get tonight is my two handouts from September and October.
That's all you have. All right, thank you. Okay, moving on to our clerk's report. It hasn't been doing much today.
Thank you, Ron. I guess it's to no one's surprise that we are right in election time. Polls tomorrow is election day, and early voting has taken place in the clerk's office for the last 2 weeks, and this is the largest voter intake that we've ever had in Lockport Township. So on the first day, we had 247 voters, which we thought was a large amount. On Saturday, in 4 hours, we had 370. Today, the last day, our office processed 528 voters that came through. Which is a total of 2,921 voters. So thank you to all the residents for their patience. My office staff did an excellent job. They were efficient, courteous. I can't thank them enough for the outstanding job that they did, their hard work and dedication to the clerk's office and to the residents of Lockport Township. I just want to publicly thank them. And they got the voters in and out very quickly. So thank you all that came in to vote. We not only handle Lockport Township residents, but our voting site is Hopewell County. So I would say probably 85 to 90% were Lockport Township residents. The rest were, we got them as far as Moline Township. So we're happy to take care of everybody. Nancy Schultz Booth's office, Will County, does a tremendous job. Their office staff helped us with, you know, sometimes we'd have paper jams, things like that that would happen. Everybody was just very good to work with, so thank you all. And we look forward to taking care of everybody in our April 2017 election, which will be on Farrell Road. So we try to get that out to all the residents also. So if you have not voted tomorrow, you can go to your polling place. There is same-day registration, so you can register to vote and vote tomorrow at your polling place. Lockport Township residents, you can call our office tomorrow. We will be happy to tell you where your polling place is located. I do want to also report that we did get a very nice email. I really like to read it to everybody. Dear Mr. Rumchuk, I'd like to say the early voting process was orderly when I was there on Saturday and everyone seemed to be well trained. I'm writing also to thank you for the chairs that were placed near the long line of people waiting to vote. I saw a number of seniors use those chairs while they waited as well. Having a place to sit can mean a lot for someone who is deciding whether to go to the polls in this important election. Thank you so much for this consideration and for all you do to make early voting work. So I'm just going to say that to election judges, I know Chuck is there, please have chairs for your seniors or anybody else that may have to sit down. It's just very important with the long lines. Also, I just want to say that our FOIA requests have been numerous, and we're trying to keep up with them as much as we can, especially with this early voting. I want to thank our bookkeeper and our deputy clerk for their prompt responses to this, and we also received an email on that. Don't mind me reading that. Dear Denise, thank you for your response. I am trying to benchmark township costs in Will County, and I sent out a similar FOIA to 5 townships. You should know that the level of service you deliver is first class. I have had other clerks that sat on the request for 10 days and then delivered a document dump. Your response and commitment to transparency is second to none. So I thank you for that, because we do try to do our best to be transparent in Lockport Township. One more thing, I know I have a long report today, if you don't mind. The Baby Youth Clinic, we had that in October. This was the largest turnout, so I think the word is getting out, and we had 6 people sign up. So the next Baby Youth Clinic will be in a couple months, and look for those dates on our website. And I believe that is all. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks.
Beyond the trustees' comments or suggestions, anybody have anything they'd like to bring up? Okay, hearing none, we'll go on to the Central Square report. When you guys pulled up today, I don't know if you noticed, we have 2 man lifts, JLG lifts out in front. We're doing a little bit of work on the building. Central Square Committee back quite a few months ago approved putting windows in the staircases in the front and the back, because they were leaking so bad, and they're back from when this building was built back in this section, probably in the 30s, was when the addition was put in. So those windows were being replaced today. They started that. Also, there's another company doing tuck pointing, which wasn't planned at the time, but there's been some leakage, mostly in your office, Denise, I guess. Or right under your office.
Yes, they were drilling away this week.
Yeah, they're going to be.
What happened last week?
They're tuck pointing that, so it's going to take care of those leaks in the building. Of course, in Central Square Committee, I wasn't real fond of the idea of putting more work into this building since we're leaving it. The price was probably on our end going to be about $3,000 was all in the capital project on that, out of the capital projects. So it wasn't going to hurt us too bad. So we did approve that. I did send to our attorney the last paperwork, I believe, for the giving of this building to the city of Lockport, the deed transfers, and there'll be a resolution next month that we'll have to approve giving the building to the city of Lockport. So that's getting all finished up, and looking forward to being done with it. We will be having our last Central Square meeting, but we will have one in December, and then we'll probably have to have one more probably in maybe January or February to pay the last remaining bills that come in late after the December meeting. And that should be the last of our Central Square. It's been together since the 80s. And there's some people on that board that's been there since the 80s, and I'd like to thank them for their participation all these years. Actually, our representative on this past story today on that board from its inception. I appreciate all she's done for the Lockport Township and for Central Square. I have nothing else in Central Square. We'll move into the new business.
I have a question real quick.
Sure.
When can we finally say that we're financially rooted in responsibility to maintenance of this building?
Maintenance of this building?
Of this building.
Yeah, this building?
Yeah,
January 1st.
January 1st.
We do have a responsibility for the 2/3 of the responsibility for the IMRF for the two employees that were here. That both are gone. She would find the attorney responsibility to pay our third, while our district has to pay their third, and the city has to pay their third. Other than that, that's our financial, that's the last of the financial.
So will there be any surplus in that fund, Brian?
I want to say yes, but every time I say yes, somebody whittles away at it, so. Yes, so we're looking at about maybe $30,000. But like I said, I don't know what's going to happen next week. But no, we don't have anything. All right, going on to new business. I put in your packet this month two contracts that I'd like to approve tonight. Last Friday, the building committee did get together and talk about these two contracts. Both the contracts are under the $20,000 amount, so we don't have to go to bid, but I did want to get a number of proposals. The first one is for the actual move from this building to our new building. I had three companies come out and look at the project. Armstrong Relocation and Companies put in a bid for $9,215. Warehouse Direct came out, looked at everything, and they, by word of mouth, said they don't want to bid it. It was too much for them, they couldn't do it. I also had L.I. Bayland come out and look at it. And I thought they were going to bid it, and they talked about bidding it. And after about 3 days, I did get an email saying that they do not want to bid it either because of the logistics of getting from where their shop is all the way down here to move everything. They didn't think they'd be competitive. So this is the only bid we got to three. So I'd like to approve this one so we can get this move and get things organized for the move. It's going to take a couple of classes and things and boxes. We've got to box everything up and get it all organized. This company said they will. They plan on doing it on a Friday in an 8-hour shift from this building to that building. Everything will be tagged and marked and boxed, and then we'll close it. My thought is we probably close our offices on a Friday and a Monday, maybe a Tuesday also, depending on how long it takes us to get all organized at the new building, and hopefully we'll be back to work and offices open on Wednesday. So, but anyway, I'd like to motion to approve this contract.
Well, I'd like to say one question, if you don't mind. The computer disconnect, pack, unpack, assembly with boot up. Is that something there? Are we going to have Velocita come in also?
Well, I'm sure we'll have Velocita. Do you think they're going to unplug the computers, pack them, bring them over, plug them back in?
Okay.
And I think that's why Warehouse Direct didn't want to do it. They couldn't do that, and I wanted to get apples to apples.
Okay.
Do you have a motion to accept this contract? Appreciate it.
I'll make a motion.
I have a motion by Jan Bacich.
A second.
Second by Barbara Weiss. Any other questions before we go to roll call? Hearing none, have a roll call.
Wondowski.
Yes.
Bacich.
Yes.
Alberico.
Yes.
Weiss.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
All right. Next contract is for the sign. We have to put a sign up front. And basically what I was thinking of doing, because I'm under the gun to get this done, I haven't had a lot of discussion. If somebody really wants to change it, we could. That's going to slow things down. But basically what I was going to do, and I did talk to the city, and we did pass it in the Central Square. I guess I should have said that in the Central Square. But they're going to let us keep our sign that is out on the side of the building. Now it's in two pillars, one on either side, brick pillars. I basically want the company to come out, build two pillars, and I want ours to have, it's gonna have a 2-foot knee wall going around the thing, so it'll be a planter, two sides that'll go, I'm not sure the dimensions, we'll get that figured out about 6 feet up, and then we'll take this thing from here and bring it over there and put between there. So I did ask two companies to come out and bid the thing. I got one. The first proposal, option A on your proposal, is without the knee wall going around it. I think it would look good with the knee wall. It's all the limestone from Joliet Lime, you know, Lockport Limestone. We are everything that replicates everything from Lockport here, so I think it would be nice to have that knee wall going around it. 13 Construction Corporation, bid at $18,900. And Ramco Company bid it at $24,300. So I would like to, since the $18,900 is $20,000 limit for going to bid, I would like to ask for a motion to approve that bid of $18,900. Dark, twice.
I'll second it.
Second by Michael Lopez. Any questions?
Like I said, I mean, so it's going to be very similar to what's out here, like as far as sidewalk and everything like that?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, the village have to be the same width apart to fit the center. The size of the square that's created for houses basically try to copy. Just out of convenience. Except that we'll have that knee wall going around the bottom. And Central Square has up on top a curb sign that goes across that says Central Square. I, you know, at a later date, once we get, you know, organized in the building, we can always add a sign, same kind of idea, saying the Lockport Township Community Center. That, you know, and it has the options to, there's three signs in there now, we can put them in there and add things to it. So, any other questions? Can I have a roll call, please?
Lundowski?
Yes.
Bosic?
Yes.
Alvarico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. All right. Oh, the other thing I want to bring up in about whole business, the one thing I didn't do yet, and I'm kind of working on it slowly, but we are a government building, and we need flagpoles. So I'm in discussions with, Lance is helping me with this, I'm trying to get our building trades to donate for a pad, so we can set the three, I'd like to get three flagpoles, one tall one in the middle, two shorter ones so we can have the American flag boldly in the middle, and our Illinois flag on one side, and we'll start with the POW flag on the other side until we design, I'd like to have a contest with our children that you did, with build a, design a township sign, our flag, so we can, township flag. So that's my plans, hopefully we'll get that done here in the next week or so. Now, the last thing I want to talk about our new business is, and I did give our attorney a copy. TOI sent me a resolution, a practice resolution for our local government travel expenses. We have to pass a resolution by January 1st because of a new law that dictates how we do our travel expenses. So I have Gary. Gave it to Gary tonight, he's going to fashion it up there for us to do for next month, so we'll have that resolution. All right, I have nothing else in new business. I'd like to go with old business, and tonight we have Jim Naylor here from the food pantry. I'd like to have Jim come up and speak.
Good evening. Jim Naylor with the Lockport Fish Food Pantry, and I'm here to have a discussion about the available space of the new building to house the current operation, Lockport Fish Food Pantry. If you'd allow me to give you a little background on information, we are a 100% volunteer organization. We service the majority of Lockport Township, City of, and then a element of Omaha. we service approximately 1,000 people a month. So that breaks down to, on average, about 250 to 300 families per month. We typically distribute quantities of food depending on the size of the family and the need. Families are available to come in or permitted to come in once a month for a true supplement to their food needs. Is there any other questions that I can answer about the organization? That's a real quick snapshot of who we are and what we do.
You're located now over the...
So we're located at 604 East 9th Street, which is the adjacent building to the Congregational Church, across from the Dollar Store, Rolling Donuts, if you will, right on the S-curve, by the Topping Muffler.
So, Jim, you said that you do 1,000 people a month, and you do it 3 days a week, correct? Monday, Wednesday, and Friday?
Correct.
For 2 hours?
Operations are 8:30 to 11:30.
Okay.
And
how many people per day, approximately?
We average, I would say, 20 families a day, or yes, on a given day. It could be 12, it could be 40. But I would say a good average is 20 plus.
You also had that truck come out one day, or? Isn't there a truck that comes
out? So on Tuesdays, we also have the Northern Illinois Food Bank that picks up donations throughout different stores that they'll go pick up excess food for distribution. And so from Tuesdays, typically it's a 1 to 4 o'clock operation where that truck will deliver several pallets of food and then we'll distribute at that time to our clients. And that's a they can come and access that at any time, you know, as far as they can access that 4 times a month.
All right. Anybody else have any questions they'd like to?
Maybe from you, Jim, I'd ask, what are you asking of the township exactly now?
So what we're looking for from the township is accessibility to a section of the building to run the operation. Our primary need is space. We don't need any type of food prep area. We don't need any type of kitchen or facilities. You know, running water is obviously going to be critical for cleanups and those types of things. What we're looking for is access to a pretty substantial amount of electricity for coolers and refrigerators, but then also open spacing for shelving and warehousing of food.
How many square feet are you looking at? Square feet would you like? Are you asking the square?
I haven't measured that. If that would be the, I'm trying to get my directions. That's the south side of the building? South side of the building there, that south wing. I haven't measured that, but from one end of that location to almost to that kitchen, that would be pretty darn close to what we're operating out of now. So we would hopefully be able to have access to that complete area, minus the, you know, ancillary opportunities to access the kitchen, but we don't need that for our operation.
Basically, we decided to move into this building. I think it was the board's feeling at the time that someday we might have a food pantry in there. So in the construction and remodeling of the building, we did leave that side of the building untouched for future possibility of having a food pantry there. Now they have shown an interest in moving in there. So what I would like to do tonight, I did have Gary write up a resolution basically saying that we're going to work with the food pantry to see if we can come to a good place since we can start looking at the
Jim, if you have, if you're looking at the same square footage as we already have, why would you leave where you're at now?
The facility that we have right now is, requires a tremendous amount of maintenance. At this point, it's an expense to us. It's also a situation where we, there may be some changes within the ownership of that building that we're not involved with at this point, and it just puts the operation of the pantry at a pretty large risk when we don't have the ability to control that location.
You rent that building on a monthly basis?
We pay utilities for garbage, some snow plowing and maintenance, as well as the some electricity. No rent. The building at this point is donated. The space and facility is donated to us, yes.
So would you think providing cooler refrigerators and that type of?
Yeah, our anticipated, if you will, equipment use right now would be a transfer of what we have. There's definitely a need for an upgrade with some of that. But we're going to be looking for some donations at that point, doing a little bit of fundraising for some newer equipment and some things that we could, if you will, adapt better to the new space, potentially, yeah.
Gary, is there any legalities that we should be aware of as the township?
Yes, as we get closer to know exactly what the parameters are, that's why the original letter was rather broad, because we need to have a chance to sit down with Jim and his group and figure out what they really need, what they're going to do, what kind of access they're going to need.
We carry liability insurance, auto insurance, directors and officers insurance, so I can provide the township with any type of information from a policy standpoint, proof of coverage for liability for our operation, but we do carry a liability policy.
Basically, what we have here tonight is, we had talked about last month doing a memorandum of understanding, basically, just that we understand where we're going, and so we can start putting maybe a committee together, so then we can talk and start having meetings to do some planning and find out who's responsible for what and what we're going to do and what they're going to do, and just to get the talks rolling. So that's basically what this resolution is about, and I would like to ask that tonight.
Gary, is there a reason why you have to have a resolution required to have talk, just have talks?
Talk later. It was just a way of giving, I think, Jim and his group a little level of comfort that the township's working on and trying to fulfill that need. But no, there's not anything you don't have.
The flow of traffic and the amount of parking spaces that you will need. I mean, I guess my concern is we'll disrupt the business of the township on a daily basis. You know, that's something that would be a big concern.
I think that all has to be discussed in the meetings, but you know, we do have a very, very large parking lot. And that south side is all parking lot. And my thought is to keep everything on that south side, which is the front and the north side.
The south end of that building plus the rear would more than accommodate the potential traffic.
So the rear entrance would be enough for you to get people in and out of?
Ideally, again, we would really want to try to sit down and collectively come up with a flow pattern for the operation, because again, it would be new. And ideally with my elderly staff and the volunteers that we have that run the operation, that would be one of the first considerations, is to figure out what would be the best, easiest flow for them to manage the operation as far as receiving clients, welcoming, staging clients, and then actually processing the food in and out. You know, the potential of an entry and an exit is something that we'd like to explore.
So, Ron, community center, there's a door by the kitchen that, that will be, that can be locked if we have to get it locked, just so that. That would be one of my concerns, just to keep it on the business of the office.
Jim and I did discuss at one point that there may be some more construction to clean up that area and work. We talked about maybe getting donations from corporate donations to help with that funding of that. And if he is able to get enough funding donations, I would like to put a door built in that exterior door, put it in that size, we can come in and help, and not be in our area at all. Would be my idea. So there would be a separate entity, they would come to the community center in case there's something going on there. But that, like I said, that all has to be worked out, and that's what this resolution is to put together, just to, so we can start talking it out and getting to know what they want and what we need, what our qualifications are, what their qualifications are to do this. Hopefully we'll work it all out and start looking forward to it.
I think based on what Gary said, that we had those discussions about passing this resolution.
Well, I understand that, but it does give federal insurance as to, you know, we are serious about this.
Well, we talked about it before, and it seems like we are serious about it. Before we make any solid decisions, I think we should probably just table this and continue our conversations.
Did you read the resolution?
I cannot read it entirely, but I do understand that.
We're not promising anything.
I understand that.
We want to talk to
them. I understand.
That's all I really think we need to do.
And I think based on what Gary had said, that we can still talk to them without passing this. Is that correct?
Yes. Yeah, that's correct. Again, I think we, I mean, it's just my opinion, it's up to the board, but I just feel like we should put our cards on the table too. Can't pass a resolution, let us pass a resolution. We're working together as a team, and if it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out. There's nothing binding or.
Jim, what was your proposed date to want to? Do you have any date that you would like to be in?
We would ultimately look at the latter part of spring, April, possibly into May. Again, the issue is the true vulnerability of where we are right now and the potential need for space. You know, the operation again is 100% volunteer, 100% donation. The monetary amount of donations that we bring in is not substantial. It's the food product that we put out. So our hope is to put the operation in a position where we're able to tremendously reduce the risk and ability to continue to serve the community more.
Do you have a lease or are you month to month?
Month to month. Actually, I mean, I'm going to take that back. We technically really don't even have any type of an agreement. It's just purely they've been extremely gracious to us to allow us to utilize the building. Situation right now where
did they give you any indication of when they would want you to vacate the premises?
They've indicated that they would work with us as long as we would potentially need to. Got a curious courtesy to them. We're trying to put a time frame on it too so they can make some decisions on what they need to.
You could read it.
I made a motion to table it, and we did not get a second, so it's open to...
Floor.
Yes.
What they did with the resolution, one through five puts Lockport Township supervisor basically authorize and negotiate everything, and not a committee. But on top, it says now therefore be resolved by the supervisor and the board of trustees for Lockport Township and the county of Little State of Illinois that. So, is it by committee that this is all going to be discussed, or just the supervisor?
You can't, this suggests it could be the supervisor of paragraph four. They didn't have to bring it back to this board to approve it before anything could be finalized.
I would like somebody to work with me on this. I should do it by myself.
I mean, it's just hard to picture this without being in this building yet, and how this building's going to work for our, well, three offices. So I think it's obviously a very good thing, but I don't know how fast we should go with this. I'd really like to see how this building flows for us. So I don't know what time frame we're looking here, but I'll go ahead and make the motion to approve the resolution, but to go on record saying that let's slow this process down, let's get in this building and see exactly how all this is going to work and how it's going to flow, how it won't interrupt government business also. With the flow of traffic, with all the utilities, garbage use, electricity use, where people are parking, people are coming in. So I really don't think we should have a flow of people going through the front door and all into the back of that building. That's not what I have the township offices should be. But if it's separated, it's toward the back. That's something that can be talked about further. But I just don't think this should be rushed through at this time. We're not even in this building. So, motion on the floor.
Under discussion, I would say if we pass the resolution, I will want to have one of the trustees work with me and, you know, get the discussions going. And I have to agree with John, I don't want to rush in anything. I just want to set the table straight that we, you know, we've always talked about the food pantry maybe being a part of it. I think the food pantry is a wonderful thing for Lockport, but I have to put the township offices in the community center first. You know, this is just basically saying, let's see if we can hammer something, work something out. So it's basically just saying, I don't want to say, nope, not interested.
That was not the intent of my proposal. My intent was more along the lines of what John had to say, that we take our time and we make sure that it's right, a good fit for all of us, rather than rushing into an agreement where, you know, we are preliminarily set one thing, and if something doesn't work out, then I'll hold the bat. Okay. So based on that understanding, as long as we all agree, I will vote for the proposal.
Well, let's go to a roll call. Unless there's any other questions, let's go to a roll call.
Mondowski?
Yes.
Bilesic?
Yes.
Alvarico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
Yes.
All right. Resolution 2016 passes. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We will start setting up a committee, and maybe I'll get some of these guys to work with me, and we'll get something on your end, we'll get some.
We'll definitely have a team there.
We're
ready to go.
Thank you, Jim, for all you're doing. Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right. That's done. The only other thing I have, a couple more things here. I did want to bring you an update of the building really quick. Basically, everything is moving so quickly right now, I can sit here for an hour and tell you all that's being done. But basically, the whole second floor is just about rugs are down, baseboards are in, the painting is done, ceilings are in. Working on the second, the first floor now. It's coming along pretty quickly. I believe the elevator will be delivered on the 11th, so at the end of this week. It should be installed, hopefully, next week sometime. They will not schedule it until it gets here. I don't know what the schedule is. Other than that, things are falling together really quick. The water and sewer is in. Water and sewer lines are in. We will have a contract to talk about next month about paving the driveway, replacing the pavement that was taken off from the patch. We're trying to get some bids for that for next month. But amazingly, it's going better pretty quick. I still think we're looking at the 1st of December to move it in. What else? I did get a... one thing I did want to bring up, I almost forgot. Everybody should have received their newsletter in the mail about 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago now. It's our fall newsletter. Make sure you go through it and read it. There's a lot of good articles in here, a lot of good what the township does for you, our programming. It has information about the shingle shots, the bus service, the highway department, the clerk's office, the assessor's office. So these, make sure you read through that. Very good. The other thing I did have tonight, I did get a thank you letter from the Northern Illinois Food Bank. As you may recall, about 2 months ago, we did donate some money to the new building. I did hear that the location of that building now is, we're talking about in the Frankfurt area. So I'm looking forward to having that being built pretty soon. I also did get a thank you letter from the Disabled Veterans Golf Benefit that we donated to last month. So, for the whole census. Other than that, I have nothing else unless somebody else has something they want to bring up tonight. I'll make a call for an adjournment.
So, second.
By John Madison, and second by Michael Madison. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Eyes have. Thank you very much, everybody, for your time.